Hi, I'm Shundra Brown, the proud principal of the Bailey School for the Performing and Visual Arts. Today, we are pleased to present a presentation from our theater arts students. It's called Me, Myself, and I, Musings from the Middle School Mind. Our students have been working hard on their monologues, and as you can imagine, doing it virtually and in person has been a major challenge, but I'm super proud of our students and our theater teachers and the work that we've been able to do together. Here at Bailey, we've been lucky enough to partner with Ms. Charmette Jones, and she's been working with our online theater students. Let's hear a word from her before we see the students. I'm super excited to be able to present this to you, and I hope you enjoy. Bye-bye.
Hello everyone, my name is Ms. Jones and I am so delighted to be here. I love working with Bailey Performing and Visual Arts. I love working online with the theater students, and we are creating wonderful, meaningful, magical moments. The masterpieces that those babies put out, oh, they just did my heart glad. We will take virtual learning by storm. You guys sit back, wait, and see what we will have for you next. Thank you, Ms. Brown, for the opportunity to serve the Bailey Online Theater students.
My name is Carmela Malabe, and I am a student here at Ricky C. Bailey Middle School, and I'm a sixth grader. Today I'll be performing a monologue, Waiting. The last 5 minutes before the end of school year has to be the longest 5 minutes in the world. Seriously, entire planets have been formed and exploded in less time, and it doesn't help that this clock is definitely broken. Look how slow the second hand is moving.
Tick tock tick. Good grief. Why doesn't somebody fix that thing? It's not like the janitor has anything better to do. I think I just saw the second hand move backwards.
Hold on, was that?
Yes! The minute hand just moved up 1 minute.
The last 4 minutes before the end of the school year has to be the longest 4 minutes in the world.
The difference between thinking about having no school all summer and actually having no school all summer is like the difference between thinking about gummy bears and actually eating them.
I mean, when you think about gummy bears and imagine eating them, it's so easy to remember how sweet they are and how chewy and that they're really, really good.
Really, really good.
Really good. I mean, gummy bears are really good.
Really good. But the truth is, the only thing that imagining gummy bears does for you is make you even hungrier for gummy bears.
But on the other hand, imagining not having school all summer, I mean actually not having school all summer.
I forgot what I was about to say.
Does anyone have any gummy bears?
Hey, my name is Raylan Clark. I'm in 8th grade and I'm performing Trust. My uncle says there's two kinds of people in the world. People you can trust and people you can't trust. The people you can trust are the ones you know are out to get you. The people you can't trust are the ones you know aren't out to get you. Undependable, I guess. I want to be just like my uncle when I grow up. He's super smart and really, really rich. He's so rich that he has a bunch of people following around just to do whatever he says. They'll even do whatever he says before he says it. Plus, he has 3 houses. 3! Like, he doesn't even use them all. So, I know he can be right about the not trusting people thing. But the only thing is, if he's right, how do I know I can trust him?
Why does broccoli even exist?
For one thing, it's gross.
Another thing, it's disgusting. And third thing, it's ugly.
Well, someone has to say it. Broccoli is ugly.
I think about it, French fries. French fries are vegetables, but they're not gross, unless they're cold.
And they're totally not ugly. I mean, hello, they're golden. And did I mention broccoli tastes bad? Yeah, basically, broccoli has nothing at all going for it, except that my mom likes it and tries to make me eat it. Did I mention that broccoli is disgusting?
I am Blake Hurley. I am a sixth grader here at Bailey Middle School, and the name of my performance is Assignment. Well, as y'all know, Mr. Patterson told us we had to write a 100-word essay about something we did this weekend. So here it goes. My Boring Trip to the Thompson Valley Supermarket by Alex Grundell. This weekend, I was sitting around the house having a really good time watching TV when my mom came in and said that I had to go with her to the supermarket. So we drove all the way to the Thompson Valley. And when we got inside the supermarket, we went right to aisle 7, which is where they keep all the cereal. And I said, can we get Fruit Loops? My mom said we couldn't because they have too much sugar in them. So I said, well, you're the one who's always telling me I need to be sweeter. Though, she didn't think that was very funny. So we got Raisin Bran instead. Then we got some chicken and some milk and some vegetables and some Hot Pockets. And then my mom asked me if I wanted anything special. And I said, yeah, the last 20 minutes of my life back. So we just paid and went home. Fortunately, I remembered to record the rest of my TV show before we left. So I got to see the end of it anyway.
Why you always in the mood? Around like I'm brand new. Tryna tell you what to do, but try to play cool. Baby, I ain't playing by your rules. Everything look better with a view. Why you always in the mood? Around like I'm brand new. I ain't tryna tell you what to do, but try to play cool. When I start to feel I'm unattached, somehow I was in a feeling bad. Baby, I am not your dad. It's not all you want from me. I just want your company.